15 things you didn't know about Rio de Janeiro. Welcome to alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. Hello, Aluxers. We're very excited to have you with us today as we talk about one of the most famous cities in the world, the marvelous city, Rio de Janeiro. Rio de Janeiro is located in the southeastern part of Brazil, the wealthiest region of the country. Taken on its own, it's the second largest economy in the country. Rio is often called Cidade Maravilhosa, the marvelous city, and is famous for its breathtaking landscape, its laid-back beach culture, and its annual carnival. The energy of its residents is legendary. No one dances more exquisitely or parties longer than the residents of Rio. Their main playgrounds are the beaches of Copacabana and Ipanema, names that easily roll off the tongue. One of the most visited sites in Rio is Mount Corcovado, with its Christ the Redeemer statue. Another is Sugarloaf, offering an impressive view of the city below. Many people go to the Quinta da Boa Vista, the park that is home to the National Museum and the Zoological Garden. With a major port and international airport, Rio is an important industrial, financial, and commercial center as well. The city has a large tourism industry and remains the economic engine for a large regional area that extends for several hundred miles. If you're new here, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and follow us on Instagram at Alux. Well, Aluxers, it's time to get started. Let's take a trip to the marvelous city. Here are 15 things you didn't know about Rio de Janeiro. Number 1. The French held it ransom. When French privateers captured gold-rich Rio in 1711, the Portuguese were forced to negotiate for its return. The ransom was 612 gold cruzados and 100 chests of sugar. The Portuguese paid up, leaving the French to enjoy the sweet taste of victory. Number 2. Street art is legal. Rio has become a giant canvas for some of the world's best-loved street artists, thanks to its liberal policy on graffiti. Providing they have permission, painters are free to spray away, adding to the rich mosaic of street art that adorns the city. Number 3. It's named after a river that doesn't exist. Legend dictates that Portuguese explorers who landed in present-day Rio in January 1502 mistook the iconic bay for the mouth of a river. They proceeded to name the area Rio de Janeiro, or River of January, which stuck despite being completely inaccurate. Number 4. It's hosted the world's biggest ever football match. The 1950 World Cup final between Uruguay and Brazil remains the highest attended match ever. Officially, 173,850 spectators crammed into Rio's Maracanã Stadium, though unofficially there were said to be many more. The game is remembered as a national tragedy because Brazil lost 2-1. Number 5. Its carnival is the world's largest. Kicking off 40 days before Lent, Rio Carnival is the biggest and brashest jamboree of its kind. Carnival in Rio started in 1723, and today it gets about 5 million participants each year. The 5-day event has nearly 600 parties taking place all over the city. This boosts the local economy to a whopping $600 million. One of the traditions of Rio Carnival is that the mythical jester runs the city. During Carnival, the mayor hands over the keys of the city to a man called King Momo. The legendary party animal then takes over the helm throughout the jamboree, but slopes off at the end, presumably to nurse his hangover. Number 6. It's home to the largest Art Deco statue in the world. Christ the Redeemer is a statue in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, that was built as a symbol of Brazilian Christianity. In 1850, the idea of building a religious monument was first suggested by a Catholic priest named Pedro Maria Bos. It wasn't until 1920 when a group petitioned for support to build a landmark statue that it became a reality. The design was chosen from several ideas and construction began in the 1920s, taking 9 years to finish. It stands 98 feet tall, and that's excluding its 26-foot pedestal, and the arms stretch out 92 feet wide. It was created by French sculptor Paul Landowski and was built by the Brazilian engineer Heitor da Silva Costa, in collaboration with the French engineer Albert Cacu, while Romanian sculptor Gheorghe Leonida fashioned the face. 5,000 people visit the Christ the Redeemer statue every day, and it became one of the seven wonders of the world in 2007. Number 7. It's home to Brazil's largest favela. Roquina is the biggest favela, or slum, in Brazil. Officials claim 70,000 inhabitants are crammed in there, but unofficial estimates reckon it's closer to 180,000 people. There are over 600 favelas in poor towns in Rio. About 6% of the Brazilian population live in favelas. Number 8. There's an Osama bin Laden-themed bar. Bartender Serrada Francisco Helder Braga Fernandez was made aware of his likeness to Osama bin Laden after 9/11. Rather than shying away from the comparison, he embraced it, renaming his Sao Paulo watering hole Bar do Bin Laden. He's also opened a sister bar, Carvena do Bin Laden, in Rio. Number 9. Prostitution is legal. Paying for intercourse is not illegal in Rio, or the rest of Brazil for that matter. And it's not uncommon to see sex workers plying their trade on the street. Rio is known for its free-spirited attitude towards sexuality. Number 10. Michael Jackson filmed there. In 1996, Michael Jackson traveled to Rio with director Spike Lee to shoot a music video for the song They Don't Care About Us. The iconic video shows the King of Pop interacting with native Brazilians. The filming of this video didn't come out without controversy, though. Rio officials were concerned that the video would only display a bad side of Rio. The knowledge that the poverty there will be used as urban misery to rebuttal all of the good qualities about the city. Christina Becker of the Rio Convention Bureau said, "We've always oriented producers to show the good side that Rio has. If Michael Jackson only wants to show the bad side, it's better he not come." Ultimately, Michael Jackson came and was welcomed by the people who lived there with open arms. The music video goes down in history as one of the best, not only for its location, but for its message. With this song, as with so many others he wrote and performed, Michael Jackson speaks for the people of the world without qualifications, boundaries, or restrictions. And now, in that same favela, sits a memorial statue of Michael Jackson. If you want to learn some more interesting facts about the King of Pop, click in the top right corner. Number 11. Rio is the national hub for creative industries in Brazil. It's safe to say that Rio is the main national hub for creative industries, arts, and cultural enterprises, as well as home to the largest national productions of TV series, telenovelas, cartoons, and TV shows. Grupo Globo, Latin America's largest communications conglomerate, is famous for its headquarters in Rio and its state-of-the-art studios, Prohac. The city houses most of Brazil's movie production, dubbing studios, and after-production companies. The second largest TV and movie production complex, Recnov, is also located in the city, owned by Reed Record, Brazil's second largest TV channel. The city concentrates the largest number of TV channels privately and publicly owned. Music production and recording companies also see Rio de Janeiro as a hub, as the city is home to Sony, Universal, Warner, Som Livre, and others. Number 12. There are more than 100 islands in Guanabara Bay. What do the Sugarloaf, the Statue of Christ Redeemer, and Copacabana Beach postcards have in common? The Guanabara Bay is the backdrop of all of them. And no wonder, it's enormous and goes through no less than 15 cities. The bay is the second biggest in the country, with its 256 square mile surface, 53 beaches, and more than 100 islands. Number 13. Rio is home to the biggest urban forest in the world. Rio is a big city with more than 6 million inhabitants, but it can feel like a small town, especially when you find yourself in the middle of a forest under a hard-hitting cascade of a waterfall. The reason for this is that Rio is home to the largest urban forest in the world, Floresta da Tijuca. This 33 square kilometer conservation area is the result of reforestation, done in the end of the 19th century on the order of Brazil's emperor Dom Pedro II. The idea was to restore the area that had been destroyed by coffee plantations in order to avoid the erosion of the hills that surrounded the city. Quite a few of Rio's most touristy spots are partly in the Tijuca Forest. The Botanical Gardens, Parque Lage, and the Corcovado Mountain are a few of them. Number 14. People from Rio are among the quickest getting on and off buses. Buses are the most affordable way to get around Rio, and they'll take visitors almost anywhere in the city. Riding in a bus in Rio isn't, however, as straightforward an experience as one might hope for. Bus drivers aren't exactly cautious, trustworthy drivers, and will often leave passengers behind if they're not quick enough to get on. With years of experience as a savvy passenger, a researcher called Ronaldo Balassiano got curious and decided to look into this social phenomenon. What he found was the fear of being left behind made cariocas to be quicker in the process of getting on and off buses. When compared to busy commuting Londoners, cariocas take 1.85 seconds to get on the bus, while Londoners take 2.4 seconds. So Aluxers, if you ever take a trip to Rio, don't say we didn't warn you. Number 15. Rio is home to the 8th biggest library in the world. It was November 1807, and the royal family of Portugal had to make a tough decision: to run to Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, to escape Napoleon and his troops. The departure was well organized. About 15,000 people among family members and servants traveled to Brazil in 14 ships. With them came one of Portugal's most important riches, the Royal Library and its 60,000 items. Now, it's a huge collection of 9 million items to be exact. The items include books, folders, serials, prints, manuscripts, maps, engravings, carts, scores, records, CDs, tapes, and videos. Together, these items represent the rich history of Brazil and its beginnings after the Portuguese colonization, documenting the Brazilian heritage. Now tell us, Aluxers, is visiting Rio de Janeiro a top of your destination list? Let us know down in the comments. And of course, as a reward for sticking with us all the way to the end, we have a bonus fact just for you. Rio has an abandoned theme park. Terra Encantada opened to much fanfare in 1998, but a series of accidents, strikes, and a violent street fight forced the $200 million US dollar attraction to close up in 2010. Its rusting remains haunt the Barra da Tijuca neighborhood. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxer. Make sure to subscribe so you never miss a video. If you want more, we handpicked these videos you might enjoy, or head over to alux.com for the best in fine living content on the planet. Be a part of the largest community of luxury enthusiasts in the world and tell your story.